Hello, my name is Jens. Today I read the Bible. The Bible title is The Strongest Man, Samson. I read, Samson was the strongest man. God made him strong. Samson was strong enough to kill a lion. He killed a lion with his bare hand. Samson even won the Battle of Philistines. The Philistines dared to kill Samson. They did the Israelites badly, but Samson was stronger than they were. I want to do whatever I want. Samson did obey God. He did obey his parents. Samson also did what made himself sad. He fell in love with Philistine girl Delilah. The Philistines came to the Delilah. We will give you a lot of money. Find out that made Samson so strong. Delilah kept asking him to tell her the truth day and night. Samson gave in and said, "My strength is in my long hair." Delilah cut his long hair and called it the Philistine. Samson later made him sad. Samson woke up from the sleep, but Samson's strength was gone. He didn't listen to God, he didn't listen to his parents, and now Samson was weak. The Philistine put him in jail. The Philistine made Samson blind. They made his world hide. They laughed at him. They were cruel to him. Samson repaired and his hair began to grow. One day, Philistine gathered at the great temple to worship their god. At the big party, the Philistine called Samson out. They made fun of him. "Samson, cut off the roof around you." "Ha ha ha." Samson repeated and prayed, "God, God, make me strong one last time. Help my tail on the peace signs. They are cold to the Israelites." God made him strong again. Samson pushed the barrier off with his might. The temple crashed down over the people in the temple. Yes, now we read this story. Ruth, Blow, Naomi. "I'm going home," said Naomi. Naomi moved to Moab with his husband and her two sons. A long time ago, there was a big famine in her hometown, Bethlehem. Naomi became old. Her husband and two sons died. Now she was living with her daughter and Rob. I ain't going back in my people, says Naomi. I am going with you. I will go wherever you go. Your home will be my home. Your God will be my God, said Ruth, the second daughter-in-law. Ruth became very with Naomi. Ruth had a pleasure food from Naomi. It was harvest time in Bethlehem. Ruth gave her grains on the barley field and eat with Naomi. Boaz wanted the land. She take good care of her mother-in-law. Ruth must be good human. Tut Boaz. Ruth get her grains made the tree. Boaz help Ruth get her more grains. He help Ruth eat with other worker complete bagley. Boaz was kind rich man. Naomi said to Ruth, in Esther room bestow are Mary the closest brother. Boaz is the closest brother and he likes you. Why don't you marry him? As Naomi said, Boaz and Ruth got married. God gave Ruth a very special gift, a baby boy, Obed. Grandma Naomi and Ruth were really happy. God bless Ruth. Now we read this story. God's man Samuel. Hannah was crying and praying in the temple. She didn't have any children. Her husband, Elkanah, was a long, loving husband. But Elkanah's another wife, Peninnah, was cruel to Hannah. Help me, God, give me a child. If you let me have a baby boy, I will offer him to you. The priest of the temple alley told Hannah was drunk. Hannah, you have to quit drinking. Hannah said to Eli, I'm not drunk. I'm praying because I'm so sad. The priest said, Hannah, God in place, God will answer your prayer. Hannah was not sad anymore. God really gave her a son. Hannah was very happy. She named is Samuel. Samuel means God answered my prayer. When Samuel was a little boy, Hannah took Samuel to the temple. I will give this child to God. Can you help him to serve God? Yes, I will help him, said Eli. The priest Hannah thanked God for Samuel. Samuel left the temple. He helped Eli and served God. Samuel obeyed God. He made God happy. He made the people happy. Hannah and Elkanah came to the temple to worship God. Hannah brought the jacket from Samuel. They wanted Eli to bless them. Bless us with more children. Eli prayed for them. God blessed Hannah with 3 sons and 2 daughters. Samuel saw God in the temple. He heard a voice calling him, "Samuel, Samuel." God was calling Samuel in the smoke to Samuel. Everything God said happened. Samuel gave message to the people of Israel. He was special prophet of God. Yeah, today we read the Bible for fun. I'm fun. Yeah, see you next time. Bye.